acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you. ancestors, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
traditional Epiphany proclamation was used back in the days when we didn't have calendars and cell phones to tell us when Christmas was. Oh, we all know what Christmas is, because it's always December 25th, but the other movable feasts throughout the year. But it's a reminder when we hear the Epiphany proclamation proclaiming, it reminds all of us of the manifestation of God throughout the entire liturgical year. And that's what we celebrate today, the manifestation of our Lord Jesus Christ to the Magi, to the Gentiles, as we celebrate this beautiful feast of the Epiphany. Of course, the poor Magi, I just hoped, are still in the closet and on the shelf. And I was going to think about climbing in between while Sister was doing the Epiphany proclamation, but I thought against it. You wouldn't want to hear a crash in the sacristy. But as we talk about the Epiphany today, you might recall on the Feast of Mary, Mother of God, I talked about Mary remembering and pondering. And we're called to ponder the gifts that God has given us. The gifts and the opportunities. And we think about that today as we talk about, you know, the Feast of the Epiphany. And once again, I turn to the Word Among Us reflection for today, talking about the Epiphany, the manifestation of the light. And I like this paragraph. Look closely and you'll find something surprising. Your light has come. The reading says, the glory of the Lord shines upon you. It's Jerusalem itself, symbol of God's chosen people, that is attracting the Gentiles, not a sudden blaze of glory come from the heavens. It's the shining witness of a people who have bound themselves to the Lord and each other. That's where the nations will find the glory of God. And today, as we celebrate the Epiphany, we reflect on the light that has been entrusted to us. The light that was given to you and me at our baptism. A candle which I will give to a child tomorrow at their baptism. The light of Christ. And this light is meant to be kept burning brightly within each of us. To fuel the light. Now we know how light is powerful. One light can be seen 10 feet away. Get hundreds of people together, the light may be seen a mile away. And if you get whole communities of people, you'll see the light in outer space. It's always neat when you see the sacred images and see all the light and you see power out of it. The light is powerful. And so the light is in each of us. And we're called to radiate the light of Christ. And what the church needs today is not another committee, not another program. The church needs disciples. The church needs us to use our gifts for the greater glory of God. That's important. We ourselves, the people of God, working and praying together. Now that's important. You know, one of the things the church needs is councils, of course. You know, in our parish, we have a finance council. We have a parish council. I try to keep it to those two councils. And I prefer the word council, not committee. Because when I think of committee, I think of death by committee. Because a lot of times when you get committees, you just get people with opinions. You get people who have a lot of thought, but not a lot of action. A council, when you come together, you seek the guidance and wisdom of the Holy Spirit. And you act with the Spirit. And that's important. We can be the manifestation of God's glory in the world. And that's what we need to think about today. We can be the manifestation of God's glory. Each and every single one of us. We need to ponder what our gifts are and use them for the greater glory of God. We are called to manifest God's love in the world and to use the gift that is entrusted to us. All of us have unique and special gifts, beautiful gifts given to us by God. Others may have similar gifts, but there's only one us. And our approach might be slightly different than another person. We're called to use that for the world, to bring Christ to the people, to manifest Christ. And so we're called to light our candles. We're called to turn on our lights. We are heading into the darkest of months. That's why Christmas is trying to do a calendar last week, February 2nd. To carry the light of Christ into the shortest and longest month. We need the light of Christ to shine on us. We need to be disciples. Truthfully, you know, while other people might have similar gifts, we're called to use our gifts. How can we radiate the light of Christ? You know, that's the thing to think about. Now, the Magi show us humility, and it says they prostrated themselves and did him homage. They opened their treasures and offered him the gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. What gift do we have to offer? We need to think about that today. That's what we need to ponder. That's what we need to reflect. What gift can I offer the Lord? What talent can I offer the Lord? What treasure can I offer the Lord? What time can I give the Lord? How can we offer our gifts? And so we're called to, like the Magi today on our speech in the Epiphany, humbly place ourselves before the Lord. To humbly place ourselves before Him. And so today, you know, again, we need to ask the Lord to teach us to love each other so that we can fill the world with His glory. To love each other, to love our neighbor. And so we're called to join the Magi today and prostrate ourselves, bow down before the Lord, to praise Him and do Him homage. The image of Jesus. Reflect on this beautiful mystery of the incarnation, God becoming like us in all things but sin, God becoming humble. And that's the thing. We humble ourselves before God who humbles Himself. That's why we kneel. That's why we genuflect in reverence. That's why we bow. We do so in humility before God who humbles Himself. And as we talk about God humbling Himself and becoming like a child, we think about God using the humble means a of the gifts that we bring him, the bread and wine, the humble gifts of bread and wine become his body, blood, soul, and divinity. We are called to humble ourselves before a God who humbles himself each and every single day on this altar. And when we humble ourselves before God, we see the manifestation of his glory. And so may we. You know what? The Magi are here in the image today. Guess who the Magi are? All of us. I just came up with that. Holy Spirit, I love you! We are the Magi. We bow in reverence, and may we pray for the church. May we pray for our leaders, our Holy Father, our bishops, our clergy, our religious, all our missionaries, all of us. May we pray for our parish and the strength of our parish as we go out into the world to bring the light of Christ to the world. We pray for our domestic church, our families, our children, our grandchildren, our relatives. May we keep asking the Holy Spirit to keep purifying us and all of God's people. The constant purification so that we can shine more brightly. And as we shine more brightly, remember, it's not our light, but the light of Christ. We can draw more people to him. And really, that's the most important thing. How can we draw more people to Christ? How can we invite more people to come here into his presence? The church, in many ways, was challenged this year. As we offer more masses, we can invite more people to mass. As we experience mass via live stream, we can reach more people who are unable to physically come to church because of physical limitations. The gospel message is going out to the world even in a bigger way. It's always great seeing so many homilies. So you get so many ideas too, from different brother priests from throughout the world. The message of Christ is being spread. The light of Christ is being spread. Let's continue that work by placing ourselves before the Lord and asking the Lord to guide us as we move forward in faith, letting the light of Christ shine, manifesting his love to the world.
graced with shepherds after Christ's own heart, who lead his church with love and care. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That national and international leaders may be empowered by the Holy Spirit in serving their people as Christ came to serve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those whose lives are darkened by the shadow of sin or doubt may be drawn into the light of forgiveness and peace through the grace and mercy of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this Christmas season may be a time to grow in the gifts God has given us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our beloved dead may be welcomed into Christ's heavenly kingdom and rest in eternal joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the living and deceased members of S. Francis and Marie Reiser family that this Mass is being offered for, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, in faith we place into your hands these prayers and petitions, those that allow and those that we hold in the silence of our hearts. And we ask you to answer those prayers according to your holy will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Oh,
truly sharing our flesh, and in communion with those who never can venerate, especially the glories of the Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, the martyrs, Peter, Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Judas, Clement, Citrus, Timaeus, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysostomus, John, and Paul, Cosmas, and Amy, and all the saints. We ask that through the merits and prayers and all things that we be defended by, to protect and help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that we hold bound, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and count upon the flock of those who have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless the knowledge and fruit is offered in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of the most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, with the bread and the soul in our hands, with eyes raised to heaven to God as the mighty Father, giving you thanks, he said, the blessing broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving him thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Christ, a place of refreshment, life, and peace. To us also, your servants, and those sinners, our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and your union according to your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always."
Let us pray. Renew by the sacred nourishment of the infant your mercy, O Lord, that the star of your justice may shine always bright in our minds, and that our true treasure may ever consist in our confession of you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before I impart the solemn feast of the Epiphany, I just encourage you, my dear brothers and sisters, as a reminder, as I say the words, build in peace, glorifying the Lord by your mind. That takes the extra special meaning in your hearts as we continue the mission of the church. The mission of the church is the mission of Christ, and we all share in that mission of Christ. Now, I'm only guesstimating that we have probably 60 people in the church this evening. And if we can reach another person today or tomorrow, that doubles that. And that's what we're called to do. Is that we are missionaries, we are disciples of the Lord. And ultimately what we need is that humility. And as one of my deacons in the former assignment, I always said, be aware of egos. And egos is actually also an acronym, ego, edging God out. And so maybe not edge God out, but we remember in our prayers and all. God is in charge, and we're called to trust Him with all our hearts and to carry the light that He's given with us out in the world. And tonight, as it is dark, if all our lights shine, it will brighten up the world. And so, may we work to brighten up the world with the Lord's love. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down with a blessing. May God, who calls you out of darkness into His own wonderful light, pour out in kindness His blessing upon you, and make your hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity.
Amen.
And since in all confidence you follow Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in darkness, may God make you too a light for your brothers and sisters.
Amen. Amen.
And so, when your pilgrimage is ended, may you come to Him whom the Magi sought as they followed the star, and whom they found with great joy, the light of light, who is Christ the Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your mind.
Thanks be to God.